10-minute time limit. Here in the corner to my left, from Pawhuska, Oklahoma, weighing 247 pounds, it is the ever popular G.J. Strongbow. And in the corner to my right, from New York City, weighing 239 pounds, here is the unpredictable Johnny Rodz.
Unpredictable is right. One of the many facets of the rather complex personality of Johnny Rodz. Johnny Rodz against Jay Strongbow. Should be quite a match here to open up things, and we're set for the action to commence.
Pausing for a commercial note. Asbury Park, New Jersey, the setting for championship wrestling on an upcoming Tuesday night. Tuesday night, the 7th day of August. Scheduled to appear on the wrestling event held in Asbury Park on the 7th of August will be none other than the Pride of Pawhuska, Oklahoma. Yes, returning its chief, Jay Strongbow. Jay Strongbow looking forward to appearing in Asbury Park, New Jersey. Joining on the card, Dominic DiNucci and others as professional wrestling appears in Asbury Park. Again, the date Tuesday, the 7th of August.
Johnny Rodz on top of Jay Strongbow, literally as well as figuratively, and Rodz really caught Strongbow off guard there, Bruno.
Yes, he did. He asked the referee to examine the knee, the brace on the knee, and while the referee was going down, Strongbow had his leg up. Here comes Johnny, who will take advantage of any opportunity, and he's been on him ever since, but let's not count this sheep out, because it won't be long, and we'll see him in there.
Strongbow on the outside, battling Johnny Rodz. Strongbow on the apron now. A couple of chops to the forehead. Strongbow back to the ropes and ready to go. Again, Rodz catching Strongbow off guard, complaining to the referee, and then from there, Johnny attacking Jay Strongbow. Face first to the buckle goes Jay Strongbow. Strongbow retaliating in his own right in an aggressive fashion, I might add. Strongbow applying pressure to the wrist. Referee warning Johnny Rodz out the clinch fist. I'm sure that warning many times falls on deaf ears. Ball back to the ropes. I believe he's close to the rope. Johnny Rodz reversing things. How did he do that?
Well, he just. Oh, there was he just coming so often.
Rodz may have reversed the hold earlier, but he paid for it.
He sure did, because again, the chief came off those ropes and he slid right underneath between Rodz's leg and shot out on the other side and got up quick. Believe me, that knee wasn't 100%. There's no way in the world he could have done that, which is fantastic to see, of course, because the chief himself said that the knee is 100%. But I think that proved it right there, Vince. Maybe that he's...